Welcome to Lohre Farm. Here's the weekly garden tour update. The potato plants are obviously flourishing quite nicely. I did get them hilled last weekend, so I'll have to go through there and see how much bigger the potatoes have gotten. Tomatoes over here. They're getting quite big and finally starting to flower, so hopefully they get pollinated here shortly. And our beets are coming through very nicely. Obviously need to be weeded. And also our snap peas are starting to grow too, so probably next week we'll probably have to start weaving them into the fence. Here are the beans, not quite flowering yet, hopefully soon. Again, we need to do a little bit of weeding. Have to come out here later when it's not so ungodly hot. These beets are sprouting really nicely. Actually, I should probably go through them because they're kind of too many in one spot. A little bit clustered and a little weedy also. Otherwise, things are coming along very nicely, getting quite big. So hopefully we'll have some fresh vegetables soon. So we're in greenhouse number one, and it looks like the beans are doing pretty good. They're not quite flowering yet, but other than that, they're growing fairly well. So I'm just going through and weeding. The kids weeded it, but kind of over-weeded, so we'll have to spot plant some beets again. Good news is they're only 60 days to maturity, and we usually pick them young because we like them smaller because they taste a lot better when they're smaller. I find when they get too big, they taste like dirt. We're in greenhouse number two. I just transplanted the peppers and they're looking good. Some of them are starting to flower here. Almost down in here. This pepper plant is already flowering, which seems a little early, but I'm not going to complain about that. And it's actually already got one pepper growing here if you look real close. And Shane's been working on hanging tomato plants, which is going to be in a video later this week. It's going to be kind of exciting to see how that works out. And then on this side, we have our squash, which is sprouting through very nicely. I did have to go through and spot plant a few spots, as you can see, because nothing sprouted up. But the stuff that did sprout up is looking really good and really healthy. And as an added bonus, we have some red clover growing, which is always nice. It's good for teas and stuff like that. Really good for skin issues if you're into eating or foraging.